Hello everyone, Timer over here, and welcome back to the channel. It has been quite a while since my last published video, and I do apologize for the content drought on our channel here. As many of you know, I recently had a kid that has just been taking up all of my free time, and it's really difficult to get some recording done. So I've been sort of doing things, you know, hit or miss here and there, but it has been many weeks now since my last video went live. So I'm going to try to get a few more episodes of a new series started here, because I've been very interested in a new release that came out, was it just recently, just last week, 2 weeks ago? I can't remember. Called Endzone: A World Apart. If you're not familiar with Endzone, it is a colony builder management kind of game, has sort of aspects of, you know, Surviving the Aftermath, which I believe we highlighted at one point on this channel. I know I played it. I'm pretty sure I did a video on it. But it has elements of that, but you're more so just like controlling the professions and resource generation of your settlement. It's a little different in that respect. We'll get in there and we'll see it. People have been equating it to games like Banished, which I personally had not really played around with in years past, but it's sort of a mesh-up of those kinds of games. So we're going to go ahead and try it out here. So I'm going to go ahead and do a new game. I have done a solo game, and just to sort of get a feel for the actual mechanics and so on and so forth. So we'll see how that goes. So there are three game modes. We've got the tutorial, we've got the survival mode, and we've got scenarios. We're just going to go ahead and do a survival mode game right here. Easy games, so various different game mode settings. We've got easy, normal, advanced difficulty, maximum challenge. Also, no trees. Start a normal, well-balanced game. Your greatest enemy is the scarceness of wood, because there are no trees located on the map. Interesting. We've got build mode. Sharply reduced, all hazards. Yeah, that's just sort of like not easy mode, but it's getting there. Relax and discover. Again, sort of easy mode. And then easy game. But we're just going to go ahead and do normal. That's all. Achievements can be unlocked in that relate to survival mode. Excellent. I don't know what that is. Map settings. We're just going to go ahead and hit next. Okay, so the map is randomly generated. So this is our C. Now we can just do... We do get a little preview of it, which is nice. So this is going to be our town center. We're surrounded by water. We've got... I like this big long mountain up here. This is fine. I like this. I like the large hills to our north. We've got a starter lake right here, but we're close by another lake in the event that we need to get those resources as well. So I'm going to go with this one. We're going to go on large map. That's fine. If you want to play on the exact same seed, just type this old seed number in, and you should be given the exact same map as I have. We're going to go here. Settlement. We're going to just call this Timeville. And we're going to hit start game. So yeah, there is a backstory. I haven't really messed around in the tutorial. I sort of just played around in survival mode to sort of figure things out. Flying in.
This looks like a good place to settle. You know what we learned in the Endzone. Basic needs come first and foremost. We have to build up a water and food supply. And then...
Okay, so we're going to go ahead and pause it. So, there is a backstory. Essentially, if you're familiar with games like Fallout, the Endzone is what would be considered the Fallout shelters in Fallout. The vaults, I should say. So it's sort of got that sort of vibe. So we've basically been in a end zone for 150 so years, and society has essentially collapsed in of itself, and there's just ruins all over the place, and we've come out of the end zone and we're trying to set up our new civilization, our new town, our new colony. This is all we got to start with. We've got a bus, that apparently we drove here from our end zone because we're not, our end zone is not right here. We didn't just pop out. We apparently drove here. And then our bus broke down in the middle of these wilderness. And we're like, okay, here's a good place to start building. So that's where we're at. We've got our water source to the north, and we've got some mountains to the, well, north. We've got our water source and our mountains to the north. We've got trees. We've got game, assuming, in those trees. We'll figure that out once we build a hunter, but normally there's brushes for hunter gatherers as well as game that we can hunt, and so on and so forth. To our south, we've got some more water, which will most likely set up some fishing huts down here, moving forward. We got a little water over here, although I don't know. My test game, I didn't really deviate from, two sources of water was sufficient to grow the population fairly high. Okay, so that's our map here. Up at the top, we've got our resources. So we currently start with 600 water, 600 food, and this is just sort of like a wide variety of raw food, essentially. We will be able to cook meals and get more sort of advanced food dishes, but that's going to be later. We've got wood, we've got scrap, which pretty much scrap is used to turn into other resources. So scrap turns into other resources such as cloth, metal, plastic, eventually electronics, those kinds of things. And medication up here. We don't currently have any medication. We've got tools. So there are two different variants. We've got scrap tools and metal tools. Obviously, metal tools are the tier two and would be better. So we're going to be focusing hopefully on making metal tools. And we've got radiation protection. So there is radiation in the game. You've got high, medium, and low radiation. And the scarfs are for low, medium, the. Me, oh my gosh, I can't speak. Low radiation protection. The mask symbol is for medium protection. And then the glove represents radiation suits, and that is for high radiation protection. Eventually, we'll want to get all the way up to all of our citizens have high, but for now, we may just start making the scarves. If we take a look at the overlays here, so terrestrial radiation, if we click on that, we can see some radiation around the map. So the low bits are green, medium is yellow, and then high is red. So we've got a little bit of high radiation over here, and you can see, and this will spread as time goes on, and it can be washed away by the rain. So this will change and it sort of ebb and flow as time goes on. We'll have little bits of radiation all over the place cropping up randomly. And if there is, may have to wait to see if we have one on the map. But there may be a nuclear power plant somewhere on this map, and that generates sort of like it just spews out radiation various times. But I don't see anything right now. Let's go back to our town center. Okay, so that's that. We've got water. So there is moisture in the soil. So this again will change over time, and we will get droughts occasionally. And all the water will dry up unless we have like irrigation going on and water stored up. Then we can keep a certain areas, crop fields and whatnot, irrigated with water and keep them growing through droughts. We've got location attractiveness. We'll take a look at that as we build houses. Got electricity, which we're going to need to actually build an electrical source. And we've got building conditions. So all those overlays are really good. Down here, we've got our sort of our season counter, and we can see a season. Season one, we're in, and then two, three, four. And it's going to tell us what's going to happen. No rain, rain. No rain, rain. And then this will also show droughts as well. What else? What else? Okay, so down here we've got statistics. We'll take a look at those at some point. We got resources. This show us a stockpile of all of our resources and what we currently have. Right here, production limits. So this basically halts our production. So by default, say we're going to gather 500 wood and then stop. Okay, so we'll be taking a look at those eventually. Now we've got professionals. So this is where it's a little different from games like Surviving the Aftermath and other things, where you basically set the profession of all of your settlers. And at least early on, you're going to be sort of like taking people from here to there and sort of juggling people around until you get in sufficient numbers to sort of like do all the things. And then you're just sort of like, you know, oh my gosh, I have so many settlers. What to do? What to do? But yeah, we'll be messing around with that. For right now, I'm just going to set, I'm going to split between builders and settlers. So settlers carry out simple tasks and help transport resources. They are sort of the de facto, you know, jack of all trades. They just do things for the colony. Sort of like your haulers, essentially. Builders, obviously, they build and will need sort of food-specific and water-specific professionals eventually. So we've got that going on. Whew, lots of talking. Okay, we're out 10, 11 minutes. So all this other stuff, this is our population. Research, we're not going to worry about right now. This is our children. So we currently have 10 adults and 5 children. Adults are the only ones that can actually work. As far as I know, okay, so the children, they do help transport food and water to their homes, but otherwise they can't be assigned specific jobs until they grow up. As you can see, Juan is about to become of age. I think each of those corresponds to a season, maybe. Don't quote me on that, but it's roughly a season, maybe 2 seasons. We'll see. But Juan is about to come of age. As you can see, that green line gets to the end. This is our comfort of, or average confidence of all settlers. So ideally we get that, you know, up to here. If we cover over, so you can see the positive effects of getting into contentness. We want to get there because we'll have a higher rate of reproduction, higher efficiency, and higher speed of movement. So we want to get up into contentedness. Right now we just got even tempered. This is our average radiation. We want to keep that low. And then our average health, we want to keep high. And this is rich food. So this goes up the more food sources that we currently have. If we just focus on fishing, for example, that's not going to really help our rich food count and thus keeping our citizens happy as well as healthy, because a higher food diversity leads to less outbreak of disease. So we'll be taking a look at that as well. We've got a game log. We want to track births and other things happening in the game. We got notifications and tasks. So there are tasks. There are like quests and whatnot that will pop up from time to time. So that is good. Okay. So first thing first, we need water. We need water and we need food. So we're going to come over here. We're going to set up a jetty on this lake right here. Let's put it, say, right there. And we're gonna need a cistern. So the cistern collects and stores water. This building requires a jetty, a well, or rainwater collector to function. Are preferred to rainwater collectors when water is collected. So basically, this is your starter storage for water. So we're gonna go ahead and just set that up right there, right next to the jetty. Okay, we will upgrade it to a water tower, but we're going to need a few things for that, mainly coal. So we got to get our sort of our special resources starting to be produced before we can upgrade it to a water tower, but it can be upgraded. This will be fine for right now. We've got a little bit of radiation over here, but as long as we're, I think, collecting over here, we should be okay and not actually get irradiated water. So that's good. Okay, so then we're going to need some food. Do I want to set up a... No, I think that's fine. We can start gathering plants and so on and so forth. But if we take a look here, we've got a fishing hut. And I think we're going to start with a fishing hut first and foremost. So where are we going to put this? Can we get that over here? Yes, let's put that right there. We're not going to be able to get Oh, wait, no, we might. No, we can't. So the fishing huts, there is efficiency attached to them. So as you can see, our fishing hut pretty much takes up this entire lake. So we're not going to be able to get the multiple fishing huts on here. We're going to have to probably move them down here if we want another fishing hut just because of the efficiency degradation there. Okay, so that's going to act as our food source. So we'll get that going. Let's set up some gathering. We can probably get rid of all of these trees safely. So I'm going to go ahead and do that because we're probably going to be building in this area. So we're going to get rid of all of that. We're going to gather scrap down here. Let's just set up a job to just gather scrap from there. And then we can set up a gather plants to right there. Because again, we're not going to be sort of looking to farm or renew this area. We're just sort of like clearing it out for progress. I think that's it. I think we're ready to get our people going. We will want housing at some point, but for now, we just want to get that food starting to come in. Do we want to set up any inventory or storage? I don't think so, because the bus wreck, I think, is fine for right now. I will set up some roads. There to there. There for now. Okay, there we go. People start doing things. So our jobs have been unlocked. We now have a water carrier job as well as a fisherman job. But because these buildings aren't actually built yet, we're not going to actually set anything up because we don't have any place to store though. We don't have the water storage yet. We don't have the fisheries yet. So, I'd rather have our people split like this and actually do jobs they can do. And then once these things come online, we will start divvying out some people. So, for example, fisheries. Let's assign one person to the fishery so they can start gathering fish for us. This is coming online, so let's go ahead and assign one water carrier. So again, it's taking from the settler pool here. Our builders are still just fine. And that is okay. Let's drop down the builders for right now. Get more people gathering these resources. And we'll get the pathways built up. Do three since we have those pathways. That is going to be a-okay. Okay. So in terms of other resources, the recyclers are what actually starts making our better, sort of our special resources, the cloth, the metal, and the plastic. So we're going to want at least three of these at some point. The tailors actually create our protection, our radiation protection. Herbal huts create sort of herbs. Well, they gather herbs, which can be used to improve settlers' health. So we're going to want that. We are going to want some housing as well. The charcoal kiln burns wood in order to produce coal. So we're going to want that as well. I think you're not doing, you're still gathering wood. I think I'm going to let them finish gathering up this area. And we'll see what we can do. I think resources. Let's get a fisher, a forestry lodge, because that only takes scrap and wood, all things we have. And I think this over here would be a better location, but we're so close. I'm wondering if we just build this over here. So you're only gathering 349 wood, but you renew it. So there's a job that allows us to plant new seeds or new trees. But I think what I'm going to want to do is put this sort of in here a little bit, something like that. And then we will set up a road Did I not? Ah! Stop. As careful as I wanted, I'm just gonna do something like this. That way, I can actually see. Okay, so there we go. Let's get it fairly close. Do I want to do it over here? No, I still want it somewhat nearby. So let's do this. Although that would chop down some trees. I could put it over here on this side and then not actually chop very many trees down. Yeah, let's do that. It's a little further down the road, but that's okay. Ba-ba-ba-da-da. All right, so the forester's there. We'll get the herbalist hut. Might set this up right by the forestry. Let's go ahead. I'm gonna, I guess I can't pause UK. Well, no, I can do ahead and deactivate. That's fine. Actually, let's go ahead and just turn that off. I'm not sure if deactivating actually removes the job from the queue. We'll make sure. Okay, I think up here might be out. Well, I might want to mine eventually right here, so I might leave this area as is and set up housing maybe down here. I don't like that, actually. We got a hunter's lodge. Now this, I don't see any game. Well, there's some game right there. I'm going to actually put this maybe right here. Now, you know what? We can move it further down. The attractiveness against this is okay. Yeah. But let's go. Let's put this. Ah. Right there. Go there. Good. Okay, so we need a forester. So someone will start cutting down trees and replanting them. That's good. All right, hunters are up. And then we can set where this job is going to be. Let's just go over there because there's some little game right there. Put one person as a hunter. Okay, and we need a scrapper. Scrapyard. This is pretty unattractive. Well, no, it's actually -4. That's fine. I'm going to put this. I guess I can't. I guess I'll have to put it right here. That'll help. That'll allow us to start clearing out these larger chunks of scrap, which I think is going to be excellent. Okay, scrapper. Let's add one person there. And yeah, that's fine. You can start clearing out the scrap over here. Not a problem. Okay, so we've got homeless settlers. We've got our basic food needs situated. Now what we need are housing. I think we'll eventually get a quest for it, but let's look at housing. So we've got two options. We've got a cabin and we've got a shelter right now. So the cabins are smaller, so less people. So they only allow for 2 adults and 3 children. And the people inside these houses, the actual adults, can have children. The shelters allow for considerably more people, but it's not suitable for generating offspring, so people don't actually have children that live in shelters. So we're going to go ahead and set up a few of these. Now, you'll see the attractiveness is only 4, and that's because we're so close to this thing. Now, maybe I should have put it up here. To be perfectly honest. Now, alternatively, we could put our first mine down here and then maybe another mine up in this area. Or we just put down decorations to get things looking a little bit better. I think I might do that actually. Let's do something here. If we look at decorations, we've got a couple different things. I'm gonna put in few of those. We are. We're gonna put our first set of houses on this side of town, just so people don't have to walk too far. We're gonna try to offset the attractiveness with a few decorations. Woo, spin around, go there, and then we'll just put a shrub right there to round it out. Logistics, dirt road. Do there. No, we can't do anything about that. Okay, so we'll get those houses up, and that's gonna be okay. Bump, 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 bump. Go to speed 3. So we'll start making babies now. We got a few more people. Because, yeah, we had one child, adult, and we just had another one. So you can see that children, when they grow up, you'll see children decrease and then the adults will increase. What you don't want to see is children decrease and adults decrease. Or not go up at all, because that means your children are kicking the bucket. Whoa, what happened? Low water reserves. Yeah, we need to get more water carriers. Woo. We got to keep up on those water carriers. So we've got the cistern, it is up and running, but we just need to keep those people kind of happy. And yeah, so we are going up there, so that is good. So now we've got housing, everybody's in a house, it is all good. Now the next thing we're gonna want is to start production. Take a look at homes. So yeah, housing is okay. We'll probably set up our next bit of housing somewhere else, a little bit prettier. The scrapper has a huge area of like unattractiveness. Well, this isn't the actual area of attractiveness, but you get the feeling. Because I think I had to go all the way out here. But, oh well. Do, 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 do. Alright, what is this? Oh, we need a. Needs goats or chickens. There's some chickens down there. Are those chickens? Yeah, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna do hunting and capturing. We're gonna go down here because we can capture these chickens and then set up a pasture for more sort of regular food. Logistics, dirt road, sugar. Well, that's not happy. Maybe I'll put the pasture up there if I can. My goodness, it is so big. Forgot how big, and we're going to be taking up some of our like wooded areas. All right, well, we'll put it over here, I suppose. And then we'll go this way. Something like that. Because something like a chicken would give us eggs as well, egg production, which would be another source of food. So that is what we're hoping to accomplish. We can get rid of you. Wood. Let's get that over there. Let's disgather plants and get rid of that. Thank you. Okay, so this is telling us we need ruins. Unfortunately, there's no pop-up for that, so you gotta keep on top of the scrap. So let's clear out the scrap over there. There, we've got some homeless settlers. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna build a shelter. What does the shelter need? We need... Is that cloth? Yes. Okay. So we actually need to get our recyclers going fairly quickly here. Yeah, attractiveness is kind of... We'll put them maybe up here. One, two, three. So we'll build three of those. The charcoal kiln we'll do here, since that's going to be our area of wood intake, at least for now. So this is going to make cloth. We're going to give it one worker. This is going to make metal, and this one's going to make plastic. And we are in an oncoming drought. Tell you what, let's make sure that we've tapped out our water carriers for right now. Because I want to make sure that we have as much water as possible. We'll be able to upgrade this to a water tower soon. Tell you what, let's focus on plastic there. I'll give you someone to start making coal. We don't have... Let's take away a builder. Alright. And then, yeah, I'm gonna double up on the plastic production. But then we'll switch this out and get that to be... What's this? The storage capacity is running low. Mm-hmm. Because what I want to do is upgrade you. I'm going to set that to be upgraded. We still have one builder, right? Yeah, we have one builder. We'll set another one to there. Actually, take that back. We now... That's right. No, we don't want that. Just do a second builder. We will want this eventually, but we don't have the metal. So I'm not going to sort of force this. Forgot it takes metal. Upgrade. Alright, so we're just waiting for the coal and the plastic. But that should start coming in. Because I'd like to get this max... I'd like to get this update or upgraded to a... what do you call it? To a water tower. There it goes. Woohoo! Alright, so that greatly increased our capacity to 5,000. Which is good. We've got three homeless. Let's take a look at housing, shelter. I'm gonna put a shelter over here, and that is gonna need wood, which we are short on. Got three refiners, hunter. Let's do that. So the wood should come in eventually. Got the scrap. We'll get cloth. This can actually be moved to metal now. You're good. And cloth. We have the cloth. We should be all right. Excellent. Excellent, excellent. Anna, Abby, so we've got a good set of children coming in. We've got an oncoming drought. People are filling this up quite quickly. Now, we can help with the drought, because the drought's going to clear up this lake. One thing we can do is set up some wells. Now, wells produce water slowly, but they do produce them during a drought. So that is definitely something that I think is worth doing. So I'm going to just put it up there. Logistics. Sort of tuck it in up in here. You're almost finished. I mean, we are running low on people. What I usually do is I will take one of our water carriers and put them into well keepers whenever I build those. You need wood. Radiation protection. So we're going to need a tailor soon, if not like right now. In fact, let me go ahead and plop that down. Tailor and shop. You are less attractive. I'm gonna put you right behind there, because there's already road. Okay, and well keepers. There we go. So someone's gonna come to this well and start draining it. It's gonna collect things slowly, but it will work during a drought, and that's what we're needing. Probably need one more to be, you know, really safe, but I think we're okay. I think we have enough water. I hope. What I'll probably do is set up another well. Just to be safe. We'll put it right there. I'm going to take one of these guys because they're no longer water carriers, and just go with here. And yeah, I'm just going to do neck scarves just so we have something kicking around. Let's get rid of you. Okay, and this is going to be our sort of our quest. It's telling us, hey, you don't have any radiation protection, so let's take care of that. Let's do that. We already have the tailoring shop built, and it wants us to make activated carbon masks instead of neck scarves. And then it's going to give us 5. So that's what I've sort of been waiting for. Let's switch this over to the activated carbon masks. We've got the coal production, so that's fine. The only difference between these two is this takes a little bit more. Basically, this takes coal. It takes the same amount of cloth. Radiation sickness takes a little bit of everything. It takes more cloth, it takes more coal, but it also adds on plastic, so it's a little bit more expensive. The activated carbon mask will protect from medium radiation. We're already unhappy, things are bad, and mainly it's because of the protective clothing, which should help soon. Alright, I'm gonna grab this, go here, well keeper's gonna go up. I'm actually gonna dump another water carrier into a tailor, as a tailor here. In fact, I could... Hooray! We've successfully completed that mission. There we go, we've got the protection now. I am gonna go and... This is fine. We'll let him finish this, and we're probably not going to be able to sustain that, but we've got some coal saved up. Coal can also be added to your water tower to filter radiation, but we currently don't have any radiation issues with our water, so I'm not too concerned. Oh right, fisheries as well don't do anything. So tell you what, let's take our fisherman and put them into a herder, and let's get this back to be built. Yeah, we're having some issues. Resources, food, gatherer's hut. Oh, gatherer's hut, we're gonna need one of these, but they're not as important at the moment. I'm gonna put them over here. We're about to come out of the drought, I think. I hope. Because, yeah, our food supply is not at all good. Where's my hunting lodge? You. Do that. Choose type of animal. Let's get chickens. So we're going to get eggs. Actually, goats. The goats do produce milk. But chickens are fine as well, because they produce eggs. So we'll do that. That'll give us a little bit more food variety. Oop. And fishermen, gather. We don't have that quite yet. Refiners might shut down. We want to make sure... Oh wait, do I actually... Oh, no, I don't. Let's just get those fishermen going a little bit more. I will get this built now, but that's okay. We'll leave the pasture going. That's going to be okay. Our water is more or less okay. Not too concerned about that at the moment. Okay, we must have had a huge influx of children, so that is good. Let's max out our fishermen. We need to rebound there. I have no builders, so let's get a builder so that this thing gets built. Ooh, yeah, we're running low on food. We'll give one gather. Actually, let's throw in a couple. I should have built that gather sooner, but that should help us stabilize our group here. We only have one chicken. Odd. Wait, no, I do have more than one chicken. Okay. Yeah, that's the chickens being produced. We're okay. There's the second one. Must just not have made it into the pen just yet. Hungry, focus on accumulating food. Yeah, well, food is now coming in. We've made it past that point. Now, one thing I could set up because of the rain, we could get rainwater collectors as well, so that we might look at next episode. That's still being good. Worked. Excellent. Got one settler. I think food is rebounding. So I'm going to actually try to generate a little bit more scrap for the moment. So I'm going to put them into scrap collecting. Just so that we can get more scrap, because it is running low. I mean, our food is by no means good, but we're about to get a huge influx of workers. So we'll do it that way. How are we going to divvy them out? Well, I'd like to set up our... get more food production going. Might be about time to get farming going. Maybe. If we look here at resources or water. Do something about culture and quality of life. Okay, this is going to give us another little thing. Metal tools produced, radiation suits, buildings built, decorations. So we've got the decorations almost. That's going to give us a reward of happiness. We'll see what we can do about that. Okay, so if we're going to farm, I might put the farm sort of up in here. I mean, I could do it over here, but this is really our buildable area. So I think we might put it over there. We got to put a cut in the video. We're moving out this way. Where am I going to want living area? I guess down here for living area will be okay. So, tell you what. We're going to put our first farming area up here. Like that. Now, I am going to go ahead and just turn this off for right now. Because I don't really want it just yet. Because we still have scrap up here and things like that. But I might actually put down a field. Okay, we might have to do it that way. Let's do well, we could get something like this. Let's do that. We don't have much. We have lupin, potato, seed there. Yeah, there we go. Five. Let's add one farmer. Again, this is going to be temporary. It's not going to be irrigated, so it's not as efficient, but it'll give us some more food options. Hunter, let's get another gather. Professionals are coming about lack of tools. Okay, we need the workshop. Understood. We'll get that going as well next episode. But we've got to go ahead and put a cut in the video. So we've got a lot of metal saved up. So I think we'll go ahead and set up the workshop probably over here and just start that production next time. So thanks everyone for watching. Hope you're enjoying this series. If you are, let me know by hitting that like button if you want to see more content. As always, I strongly encourage you to subscribe to the channel. Otherwise, we'll see you next time, folks. Bye-bye.